Okay, good morning students. Now we are going to start with the second chapter. As in first chapter, we had taken the overview on the construction materials, in which we described different types of construction materials like a natural material, artificial material, then process material, recyclable material, and all the others. So in second chapter, we are going through the natural construction materials. What are the different types of natural construction material? What are their properties, types, applications? Okay, so let me start discussing the natural construction materials. So here it is, the list of natural construction material, in which first is stone, timber, bituminous materials and the mixtures, then lime and the soil. So first, stone. As we know that it is a natural material available which having the good strength, durability, then it is a non-porous structure. That's why it can bear a heavy loads. So in many foundation works, we are using the stone as a primer material. Okay, so the requirement of stone, its structure, then appearance, then weight, fineness of grains, durability, strength, hardness, and the facility of working or the dressing. Okay, so for a good stone, we having a requirement like a structure, it having a regular structure without pores or the holes, then it having a color of black, and the weight, it is depends on the stone utilized for the different construction works. The fineness of grains, durability, strength, hardness. So here it is, types of stones, that is igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and the metamorphic rock. Then stratified, unstratified, and the foliated rocks. Then third, that is siliceous, argillaceous, and the calcareous. What are the different uses of the stone? As I mentioned, if it having a good durability, it is non-porous, it can bear a heavy load, then it can be utilized for many kind of works. They are used in hydraulic structures like dams and the bridges. Then they are used in retaining wall masonry to retain the soils. It is also used in embankment works. They are used as a road metal in a road construction. As in first chapter, we have gone through that the stone is a main component in the road construction, which having a good crushing strength, impact value, then compression strength, and that's why it is a main or the major component or the constituent in the road construction. They are used as a ballast for the permanent way in the railway. The ballast are nothing but a layer of stones below the track, okay, which can sustain a load, which can repel all the loads coming over the foundation. Then they are used to make the concrete in the form of coarse aggregate. So in concrete, as we know that the aggregate is involved, which can gain a load or which can having a good compression crushing strength. So these are the uses of the stones, and this can be utilized for many structures. In properties of the stone, as the siliceous rocks are hard and durable, they are not easily affected by weathering actions, which having a main contain as a silica, that's why it is called as a siliceous rocks. Then argillaceous rocks may be dense and compacted, or they may be soft. Okay, so the different rock or the stones having the different properties, and that's why they are utilized for the different works. As we know, the sandstone, limestone having a different properties, and that's why they are used at a different locations. Then the durability of the calcareous rocks will be depend upon the constituent present in surrounding atmosphere. Sometimes, as we know that due to the weathering action, rocks having many faults or the fissures in it, and due to which their property changes. Then like a marble, quartzite, like a marble, granite also having a different property. Okay, they are in crystalline structures, and their properties different than the siliceous rocks, or we can say that a basalt, as we utilize the basalt as a main component of foundation, but cannot be utilized for the aesthetic use or like an interior decoration, as we are using the marbles, granites for that purposes. Because they are having different property, they cannot bear a heavy load, but that due to their textures, due to their shape and size, they can be utilized in the interiors. Then igneous rocks contain many minerals, various minerals having a wide range of different distinctive characteristics and the properties. Then the lime, the requirement of lime. It should be set easily. It should have a low shrinkage, so cracks will not be present in the structures. Then it should not contain impurities. It should be moisture resistant. Then it should slake easily with the water. So it should be mixed with the water easily. Okay, it should not have a moisture resistant. Sorry, it should have a moisture resistant. Then it should not be containing impurities. Okay, so that is a requirement of the lime. Then what are the types of lime? First, that is a fat lime. Then hydraulic lime. In hydraulic lime, there are some types like a feebly limes, moderately, and eminently. And last type, that is a poor lime. So that depends on the properties of the lime. As when we mix the lime with the water, then it suddenly co get compacted or solidified. So it should have some resistance to the moisture, because if the moisture content increases, it will be remain in a plastic stage and will not get a required shape. So that's why it should have some resistance to the moisture. Okay, then lime is used in the treatment of water and the wastewaters. Then it is used in the manufacture of the glass, in refractory sand, lime bricks, and the paints. So due to its property, it can be utilized for the manufacturing of the glass, then sand, lime bricks, and the paints. Then it is used for the lime mortar for masonry work of the buildings. Sometimes it is also used for filling up the gaps or the cracks between the structural components. Then it also utilize to get filled into the gaps between the tiles, or the gaps between the granite, or the frame of the windows and the doors. So that's why it cannot be utilized for the construction work, but can be utilized for some of the repair works. It is used for plastering and whitewashing of the building. Mainly, this is the first primary function of the lime, that it is utilized over the wall surfaces as a whitewash, over which we are applying the paint. So it gives the good surface area and the adhesive properties to the paste. It is sorry, paints. It is used as a lime concrete to make the waterproof structures. As I said, it is used for the many crack filling or the repairing works, because it having a good property or the good bonding property. That's why it can bind the different materials together for joining, or the gaps filling between the tiles, or the gaps between the window frame and the main wall, that also filled by using the lime. Then lime is uses in the treatment of water and the wastewater. Then next material, that is a timber. Timber is a natural building construction material. Okay, previously it is highly utilized for the construction of houses, but now we are generally using a furniture of the timbers. We cannot utilize the timber as a building component, because during high compression it will get failed. It having a good tensile and the compression properties, but not that much as compared to the steel and the concrete. That's why nowadays it cannot be utilized as a component member of the construction work. So here it is a requirement of good timber. First, dark uniform color, then denser structure, वर्केबल एंड गुड मशीनेबिलिटी, द यूनिफॉर्म टेक्सचर, फ्रेशली कट लॉक सरफेस शुड बी इमिट अ स्वीट स्मेल, देन फ्री फ्रॉम द क्रैक्स, स्प्लिट्स एंड द रैप्स, देन व्हेन इट इज स्टक इट शुड प्रोड्यूस अ सोनोरस साउंड. सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द गुड टिम्बर. सो इट शुड हैविंग गुड यूनिफॉर्म कलर, देन इट इज अ डेंसर स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, देन द स्ट्रेंथ और द ड्यूरेबिलिटी मेनली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ग्रेन साइज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. द ग्रेन साइज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज लॉन्जिट्यूडनल, देन हॉरिजोंटल एंड इन वर्टिकल मैनर. सो मेनली द स्ट्रेंथ डिपेंड्स अपॉन द टेक्सचर, और वी कैन से दैट द ग्रेन साइज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द ग्रेन्स. देन वर्केबल, इट शुड बी वर्केबल एंड द गुड इन मशीनेबिलिटी. इट शुड गिव अ गुड, वी कैन से शेप, और कैन बी इजिली मोल्डेबल. देन फ्रेशली कट लॉक सर्फेसेस शुड इमिट अ स्वीट स्मेल. ओके, सो फ्रेशली कट लॉग, और वी कैन से द टिम्बर शुड गिव अ गुड स्मेल और द स्वीट स्मेल. देन इट शुड बी फ्री फ्रॉम द क्रैक्स, स्प्लिट्स एंड द रैपिंग. दीज आर द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द गुड टिम्बर. देन नेक्स्ट टाइप्स ऑफ द टिम्बर, दैट इज नेचुरल एंड द इंडस्ट्रियल. नेचुरल देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स लाइक बाबुल, बाम्बू, बनियन ट्रीज, नीम, मैंगो, टिकवुड, पाइन एंड द पाम्स. देन इन इंडस्ट्रियल टिम्बर, वेनियर्स, प्लाईवुड, फाइबर बोर, इम्पर्ज टिम्बर्स एंड कॉम्पर्ज टिम्बर्स. सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द टाइप्स ऑफ द टिम्बर्स विच कैन बी यूटिलाइज इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क्स. In uses of the timbers, as we know that previously the timbers are utilized for the construction of the houses and also the sleepers of the railway. Sleepers are nothing but the tracks provided, or the these are the beam like structures provided over the boulders. Then bridges, pipes, furniture, packing material, decorative pieces, doors and windows, matchbox, boat, roofs, lintels, flooring and partition wall and the rafters. So all that components are made up of by using the timber works. Nowadays it is replaced by concrete and the steel. So here it is about today's session. We will continue with the next session and same chapter. Thank you.